racing through a mega bubble.
Yes.
But first,
Marty Jobson explains the science behind what makes bubbles, well, bubbles.
Who doesn't love bubbles? These perfect spheres of liquid are one of nature's wonders.
Blowing a small bubble is child's play. But I want to see if I can blow the biggest bubble possible. For that, I'm going to need something more substantial than this.
To beat the record for the world's largest free-floating indoor soap bubble, I need a bubble over 2 meters in diameter. This is going to be a monster.
I'm forever blowing bubbles.
To give me a hand is physicist Cyril Isenberg, who has been studying the peculiar properties of soap films for over 40 years.
Cyril, why is it that if I blow into pure water like that, I don't make bubbles, they don't survive? What's going on?
Well, that's because the surface is not flexible, and when you produce a bubble, it's unstable and bursts and releases the air.
Soap produces a flexible surface because its molecules have split personalities. One half is oily and likes to be out of the water, like a cork that floats. The other half mixes well with water, like a coin. When the two are stuck together, something special happens. The molecules spontaneously organize themselves in a layer. This quality makes soap good at cleaning greasy pans, helping the oil and water to mix. And it also makes the water surface elastic.
It needs a little stir with my scientific instrument here.
That's a loo brush.
Yes. but I never used it in the loo.
I wasn't going to ask. So we've added soap.
The surface is flexible now. It's got these soap molecules in the surface. So when you blow air, the surface will flex and encompass the air in the form of a bubble.
In a bubble, 2 layers of soap molecules trap a thin layer of water. It's a soap-water sandwich. But for a giant bubble, the real challenge is to stop it from bursting.
Why do they burst then?
Because of evaporation from the surface. A small hole appears in the film, and this rapidly expands, and bang, the film is gone.
Anything that reduces evaporation will help.
The magic ingredient for super bubble mix is this stuff, glycerin. This loves water and it'll hang on to it and stop it evaporating.
To make the bubble mix, I'm using 1 part glycerin, 10 parts washing up liquid, and I've made it all up to 100 parts with pure, clean water. But what about the wand?
Does the shape of the frame make any difference to the shape of the bubble that it produces?
No. Any shape will always produce a spherical bubble, because it will always want to take up the surface with the minimum area associated with that volume of air, and that's a sphere. That's always a sphere.
For my record attempt, I'm building a giant, flexible wand to help me seal the bubble.
Well, I've got my mixture, I've got my wand, it's bubble time. All right, here we go. A nice big film of bubbles. Oh, it was close. Nope. The mixture's working. The problem is closing the bubble at the end. Oop, too quick. I'm going to try adding a bit more glycerin. Lift and separate. Walk back.
For a split second, we got it.
Well, that was definitely a bubble. Question is, was it big enough?
Just before it burst, we got a complete sealed bubble. It's a whopping 1.84 meters diameter. Not quite a world record, but certainly a personal best.
The only way to celebrate our bubble attempt is with a bottle of bubbly.
Oh. Wonderful.
Cheers.
Well, Sam, the bubble man, is the world record holder for the world's biggest bubble. Nice to see you.
Nice Marty to see was you, Sam.
So we saw Marty was having real problems closing off there.
Yes.
You obviously didn't have so many problems closing off. How big was your bubble?
Well, it was about the size that, you could fit a small car in it, for sure. But
oh, wow.
3,300 litres of water you could fit inside it, too.
It's very impressive. Goodness and you've me. Been forever blowing bubbles, pardon the pun. Very, very cheesy. I was going to say very
good.
Matt Baker.
Oh, thanks.
you know what I mean? When did you start and how did you start? I mean, where did the fascination come from?
It started back in 1989 for me. I had a kind of bubble epiphany.
Right.
It was kind of the moment of inspiration whilst watching a bubble. And then I turned professional in 2000. It stayed as a hobby until 2000. And now I get to fly all over the world doing fun things with bubbles. I did the opening ceremony of the Olympics. And
right.
I made bubbles for all kinds of fun people, including you.
Brilliant.
Excellent.
Well, listen, earlier on, Guy here took on the role of Sam's bubble assistant. and now we use the slow motion camera for this. You like this guy?
Right,
have a look at you there. Look, you're going through a bubble.
Oh,
now,
yeah,
this, Sam, this has never been done before, has it?
That is a first. That is a first. The best of my knowledge.
Yeah.
It's never been done before.
Is that right? You haven't cheated that. That is right, is it?
Yeah.
No, that's
well,
right.
You were doing it.
I think I had my eyes closed at that point.
Scariest thing you've ever done.
Yeah, well, that's a trick.
You also showed us your bubble net, which is beautiful as well. Let's
yes.
just have a look at that. There it is.
So this is what I invented, actually, originally to... Well, my dad gave me a dying wish to scatter his ashes over the cliffs of Cornwall with... In bubbles.
In bubbles.
Yeah.
Oh.
So, which is a windy old place, so I invented this net to work with that. And then, in fact, I got picked up by Danny Boyle, who asked me to develop the idea, and we had 55 people using them at the opening Olympic ceremony.
Oh, what a beautiful way to do it.
Bubbles, pretty bubbles.